I'm working on the installation of the pallet magnets. These are on the bottom of the calliope or on the top of the wind chest. The pipes will be pointing in this direction. You can see the micro switches. The air hole going to each pipe is 5/16 diameter, and the pallet that's covering that is 5/8. I made up a little jig with a 5/16 dowel, and this hole is 1 3/4 inches away. I can take a pencil and draw a line across there. And I had these other lines already sketched in here to line everything up. The screws going in are a number 6 sheet metal screw. Drilled a number 47 pilot hole and ran this in with a cordless and ran it up and down a couple of times, nice and gentle. This is no time to be snapping things off. You can take the pallet magnet, slide it in there. Make sure that the pallet is lined up with this so you know that it's over the center of the hole. And you tighten this down until these little dogs dig into the wood. That's on there quite firm. This configuration makes it easy to wire. I can run the common wire, will zigzag back and forth between this post. And on this one over here, it'll zigzag, come up to here, pick up this one, back to here. And then these four rows will be tied together. And there will be a diode between these two terminals. All the magnets have been wired. You have the common wire that zigzags back and forth. And then this red wire feeds these two banks of magnets. And then this red wire here feeds these two banks. The diodes are in place. And all of these wires come across and pass down below to the micro switches. And from the micro switches, the wires will come back and come up through the board here and then go out to the magnet drivers. And I was using these small zip ties to hold these wires to the coils. The way I had it before, these wires were coming up to the magnets. I had the coils in them. This is a stranded wire, and those coils kept sagging, going places I didn't want. The pallet magnets have a bar right here, and it's actually what holds the bumper for this thing to bounce against. And there's a little gap between the coil and there, and just enough room to use one of these small zip ties. But I've lost a lot of blood off of these things. They're very sharp when you cut them off, and I decided to get rid of all of those. I used a waxed flat braided lacing tape, same as what is used for lacing wiring harnesses inside aircraft. There's plenty of room for that to go around there, and if you follow the proper procedure, the wax lacing tape is fairly easy to use and will not come undone. I went back and retied all of these and did exactly the same thing on the microswitch side. Get rid of the zip ties. You know, the problem with most of the zip ties you get today, after a while, they dry out, crack. You can't depend on them. This you can depend on.